when I started this re-record all of yesterday, I wanted to do a better job than I did on my original. And unfortunately, I forgot a couple of things that we need. And this upsets me greatly because now we have a small little backtrack. One of these items I did mention, that is this briefcase here we need to go ahead and pick up. Nab that. The other one is in the room where we fought that scorpion. So go up the ladder. I don't know how I saw this thing on my original playthrough. Probably running around just checking for items, which is part of why I didn't really like that LP. It's not real good when I don't know where items are, generally. So now we gotta go all the way back to that area to put this ice pick in to give that to Rebecca. Fortunately, Billy will run a little bit faster since we don't have a gun equipped. And while we're on the way, I'm going to tell a story. So I've heard of the theory that guys and girls can't be friends without somebody assuming that they're dating. And I've experienced this with at least 3 or 4 friends that I've had in my lifetime. Apparently, guys and guys can't be friends either without people assuming. I was at a bar once with a guy and girl that I'm friends with. And the female friend of mine had one of her female friends come join us. While she was there, this girl decides to ask about me and the other guy, "So, are you two together?" Because this guy is actually gay. And I'm just sitting here like, why the fuck would you assume that? And this isn't a gay-straight thing. It just, why would you assume that when we've given you no reason to think anything? And that's the same for any girls I've been friends with, too, that people have thought. I don't understand that. I think people are retarded. Okay. I don't know. She doesn't seem like the smartest person in the world, so... I mean, I've seen people before that have given definite reason that you would think that they might be a thing. I should have picked up the shotgun shells, actually, while I went all the way back up there. I really wish this thing would auto-send without me having to confirm that. Okay, now that we've got that over there... You know, it's just an annoyance is all. I noticed during editing I did not actually click on that, so I did now. Let's go ahead and nab this, so that we can leave this place. Although, to be fair, right now, this is the safest room on the train. Though, it's a classic-style Resident Evil game, so you know at some point, no room is going to be safe. There's always a timer at some point. Pick the lock. Fantastic. Out the door. Rebecca, there we go. Each time I've tried this section, my reaction there gets much less stressed.
This way.
Okay.
Okay. Join them up. Yeah, I told you to join me even though we're coming right here. Inventory. Got a couple things to do here. I want to give this red herb to Rebecca, so she can combine them. And I think that's everything I want to do right now. I really should not have gone through the menu like that, or exited the menu. Swap back to Billy, because he's got the item we need. Wouldn't you know it? I keep forgetting all this. There's way too much menu juggling in this game. Equip that and use that. And I don't like that they also give you only 6 slots per character given the inventory system in this game. They should have given you 10. Okay, so as soon as you get through this section, start shooting. Come on. God damn it. My original run, nobody got hurt. But, well, that's not what happened this time, is it? Okay. That. And that's why I feel like I should have just gone ahead and taken those shotgun shells. First aid spray. I don't need it right now, but I want to tell the game that I did see it. That is something that we can combine. How is my health? Still fine. We can combine that with a couple of other items later, and it'll be useful. Alright, if the game would stop telling me shit, there's an item right down there I want to pick up. Thank you. That. Combine, and we get that. We still need one more. Actually, I'm going to want Rebecca to do this. No real particular reason I want Rebecca to do this next segment. Exchange. There we go. Once I actually looked at that. I don't know why I want Rebecca to do this next segment. I just kind of do. I think I feel like this just seems like more of a game that focuses on Billy, and I want Rebecca to have something to do. Alright, bring her over here. Oh wait, what the hell am I doing? I want Rebecca to do this, which means she stays here. Okay. This is the first puzzle where you use both characters. I don't know why it didn't switch me over, though. But it worked out good enough. This is basically a grappling hook. This is just instructions on how to use said grappling hook. If you're playing the game, then you'll get that file. If you're... not activate that thing to the left, because I don't really want to deal with having to get out of another menu. If you're watching this for fun, then you don't need to worry about what that does anyways, because you'll see. Okay, they're both with. That's good. That should unlock that door, which is cool. And a zombie should show up and attack. Oh, there he is. Whoa. Dead. Alright. Make use of that reload. In-game reload. That is the one thing that I do quite enjoy about these remasters. I think some zombies are going to come up here. I'm going to try to run. If I get hit, I got an herb. I don't really want to waste my time if I don't have to. Billy, let's go. Don't worry about them right now. By the time we go back through there again, there will be plenty of zombies. Now, we will want to take out any zombies here. Dead. Okay. I love me that reload. Alright, the game was being a twat about this the first time I tried this. Hopefully it won't be this time. And it's gonna be. There we go. About friggin' time. The problem is I think I have a full inventory. I got something we need to pick up, so that's going to be odd. The good thing is we can drop items, so it's not the end of the world. Oh god. Anybody else? Just bring it! Just bring it! Fuck you up, man. Fuck you up. Ooh. Well, we don't actually need the hook shot right now. Yeah, that'll work. Cool. Alright. We won't need it again for a while. Nab that. And I'll go ahead and meet up with Billy before we mess with that. I'm going to want to unequip my gun to do this. We saw a brief part of this section last time. Run. Just run. Yeah, they do move a lot quicker actually without the gun equipped, which is nice. Okay, re-equip the gun. And we're pretty much done with the train. Okay, so now I want to save. Oh, right.
Follow me.
Come on, okay. Billy. I want to save before doing the next thing we got to do, which is going to involve item management. I'm going to go ahead and try to figure out what items I want to carry and everything like that. So I will meet y'all back here in a second. I forgot a little bit of inventory management we need to do. We need to examine the jewelry box thing, the little ring box looking thing. It will give us a ring that we go ahead and add to the briefcase, and that'll go ahead and unlock that, and we'll get this card key. After that, I'm going to go ahead and give that to Rebecca. I picked up all the items I want to pick up. This is the inventory I will be going with. I just want to hang on to certain items, and that's why I picked the ones I picked. And I think we will get an opportunity to save before doing this next part. And I'm going to be doing. Yay.
This is Delta Team. This is Delta Team. We have gained control of the train. Over.
Understood.
This does not make any sense. How was the T-virus leaked? And why did it contaminate both the lab and the mansion, as well as a train almost 3 miles away?
That's irrelevant. We must make sure no knowledge of this gets out. Destroy the train. Completely. How far away are you from the nearest branch line?
About 10 minutes, Duke.
Huh? What happened?
if you're playing this for the first time, you might consider going back and saving before doing this next part. That's what I did.
Oh, we actually have to walk this. Okay. For some reason, I thought we got an automatic cutscene, but alright. That's cool. There's a door around here somewhere. There it is.
The train will either derail or crash. I gotta stop this thing.
Yeah, I know what I need to do. Kind of. These are more game mechanics. You don't need to worry about them unless you're playing the game, and again, you'll get the instructions. Okay, which will stay behind? Billy will stay behind.
I'll go over to the back deck and manipulate the control panel for the brake. You stay here and apply the brake when ready.
Okay. Rebecca!
Huh?
Don't screw up, okay?
I won't.
Okay, so there is a card we need to pick up. Thank you. Yeah, we do gots to go. I got her 3 full heals, so hopefully that'll be enough to get me through this. Run your ass off. Well, stop making love to the zombie and run. Okay. I guess she wasn't making love to the zombie. That would make her a zombie file, which I would totally judge her for, because damn it, I got the hots for her. Okay. I know I'm going to get eaten on in some of this stuff. I just don't want to waste the time fighting. Oh, I knew it. My original actually dodged the asshole. Get off! Jerk. I actually, on my original, dodged that guy. I don't know how in the world I did it, but I did. So I just... Oh, crap! Crap, 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 crap. Not good. Get off. Alright, that defeated the purpose behind that. So, handgun. I went ahead and gave her Billy since it's a little stronger. Run back. I think I can take another hit. Oh, balls. I hope I can take another hit, because otherwise I'm going to die. Alright, if you fall to the ground, that's cool. Oh, I hope I can take another hit. I don't want to use a health item. I actually don't mind redoing this if I fuck up. Poor Eddie. Take a seat. Actually, I take that back. And unequip. I need her to run faster, so we're going to use an aid spray. A fade spray. Run. Run. I don't know how much time I got left. So run. At least this isn't like Code Veronica, where during the door loading sequences, the timer's still going. I think Remake, it still does that. I can't see my character. There she is. It's intense! The timer! Done got me! Okay. I think I'm going the right way. I hope I'm going the right way. I am. So we come over here. Oh, thank God. I was worried she was going to go through the door and I was going to be upset. Right. Here's that card. Seven.
This is just a simple math puzzle you have to do, and fortunately the game will let you pause it to go ahead and figure it out, which is how I had time to figure it out.
This is Rebecca. I have engaged the control device for the brake. Over.
Roger. I'll put the brake on now.
And do the same with this section here, just a different number. Immediately equip a weapon. Because there are going to be zombies in here. Get him. I don't know if there are any other ones around here. I remember when I first played this just being surprised very much by zombies being here. If you take a look around here, all of our shit from the train gets brought back here. Unfortunately, even the combat knife, which we don't ever need again. The hook shot is in here somewhere too. I don't know where the fuck it is. I'll come back for it whenever we actually need it. In the meantime, I need to find a door. Here we go. I remember this area giving me a lot of trouble trying to find my way out of it on my original run, so I'm very happy that it did not cause me that much of a problem this time. Up down. I'm not really quite sure why my controller's vibrating there, but okay. This reminds me of the sewer section in 3. I don't know why they had to have a sewer section in that game too, but at least it was very, very short. Pretty much just exactly like that segment we just walked through. Of course, you've seen Resident Evil 3 on my channel, right? Right? No? Fuck.
The Umbrella Research Center? First general manager, Dr. James Marcus.
Who on earth are those people?
She's just a rookie, a member of STARS.
What about the male?
I'm unfamiliar with
him. Attention! Mm-hmm. This is Dr. Marcus. Please be silent as we reflect upon our company motto. Obedience breeds discipline. Discipline breeds unity. Unity breeds power. Power is life.
Who are you?
It was I who scattered the T-virus in the mansion. Needless to say, I contaminated the train, too.
What?
Revenge. On Umbrella. Ago, Dr. Marcus was murdered by Umbrella. You helped them, didn't you?
His revenge? He's gonna get his revenge by singing. Sorry, I was distracted. I was trying to look at something. Okay, so if we come down here... There should be an ink ribbon. Let's let Billy pick that up since he has one. Well, handgun bullets, which he'll actually need now that Rebecca has all of them. And there are herbs down here, which I will worry about at some point if I need them. When I need them, because I'm sure I will. Come up here. Okay, there is a room I'm looking for. Might take me a second to find it.
You stay here.
Yeah.
She's got the most space, so we'll take her. I think it's here. It is here. Beautiful. So let's de-equip our gun. I think there's a file. And there's one other thing we need in here. And I was going through this way too quickly. I apologize for that. But by now you should know to pause it if you want to read it. I am sorry. I did mean to not do that so quickly. There we go. Nab that. And let's get the fudge out of here. Game. There's a door right there. Okay, thank you. Thank you. Thank fuck. Okay, and there's another little trick that I've seen somebody else do. Call her, and you can go through here.
This way.
Roger.
It's a way, if you're going for time, you can kind of cheap it up a little bit with the partner system in this game. It's kind of cool. So this area is going to be a major area we will be back to a lot. I remember my original LP, I started off or ended off videos here a lot. There should be... I really don't like these descriptions of things. There should be shotgun shells right here, but I can't see them because Rebecca's in the way. And instead of actually picking them up, the game is describing shit that I don't care about. Thank you. Okay. And more ink ribbons. Awesome. So I'm gonna save. And now let's go ahead and explore this lovely place. Do it as Rebecca. She's sexier. And I can't find my way around things. Actually, I'm not doing that terrible, all things considered. I thought there was a file on one of these things. I was going to show it off. Is that it? No... It is not. Kind of looking around for it, but I'm pretty sure there is a file over here somewhere. Oh, there it is. Becca. There you go. Who's a good girl?
Rebecca is.
For the time being, anyways. Yeah, I'm really digging this kind of creepy music that they're playing here. They generally did a pretty good job with the atmosphere in this game. It's not as good as Remake, although they fucked it up on the remaster, which does irritate me, but, you know, they still did a really good job. Ah, there's a podium. Ah, seize me a podium. Rebecca, she's got to give a speech. Ladies and gentlemen,
you're gonna die! You're gonna die! You're gonna die!
No? Rebecca? Rebecca, put it down. That's not the way you do this. It's not the way you give a speech. Say nice things to people.
I'd like to thank the Academy, all my fans, my mother, and Jesus. Thank you.
That's the closest thing I could do to giving her a bow. Let's get out of here. Okay, this room has a series of doors. Finding one that's unlocked for me can be problematic. I don't suppose I can cut through over here. I can. Sweet. I do have the blindness. And this is where the game does something I kind of tried to talk about. That. They bring back the moaning. Which is so cool. I am so happy they did that. That's one thing Remake was missing. Okay, I'm just running here to make sure all the zombies are dead. I think they are. Alright. I'm getting tripped up on camera angles. That's awesome. Come in here. And there will be a few goodies for us to pick up. One would be a map. Very nice. You can let me out of there now. I don't need the map anymore. But thank you, game. There is... Do I have enough space to pick it up? I do. Microfilm A. I don't know what that's used for. In Resident Evil 2, the films that you could pick up were just giving you pictures, one of which was actually of Rebecca in a basketball outfit. It was in Wesker's desk for some reason. I'm not really sure why he had that, unless he just had the hots for Rebecca, which I can't really blame him. I don't think... Oh my god, camera. Camera! Camera! Camera, work with me. Yeah, okay, there's not anything useful. Maybe the camera was trying to help me there? I don't know. Okay, there's one other thing. This is going to be something we're going to do mostly in the next video. Cool. I thought Billy might have been the one to pick this up. As you can see, we just used that item there, and that's one puzzle piece down. In Resident Evil 1, the only film you got just showed Kenneth being killed. Oddly enough, Kenneth being somebody from Rebecca's team. So, that's pretty much it for the time being. I'm going to go save, and I will meet y'all back here next video. So, thank y'all very much for watching, and I will see y'all next time. Bye, you sexy people.